Welcome to the Vuvuzela. Today we've got Colette Bundy from Bolito Pro, who's going to be chatting to us about the postponement of Bolito Pro 2020. Welcome, Colette.
Thank you for having me, Mandy. Yes, so the event has been cancelled, and we see it as a very positive thing because the Bolito Pro has been around for 50 years, as you know. We recently celebrated the legacy of the event, which was 50 years, and through those 50 years it's evolved. It has been many things, and we're going through another revolution as we speak. I think some of you may know that the event was going to be progressed into a Challenger Series, and the Challenger Series is a new element for the WSL, and it would have taken place this year. And with the cancellation of most events around the world, it is just going to be a postponement of that. So there was going to be a new element to that event anyway. The Challenger Series is going to be a lot more exciting for the event from a sporting perspective. It's actually, the WSL are working on a whole new program where they have recategorized the way they're going to do the tour. So the QSs are going to be more regional events, and the QS 10,000, which was what the Bolito Pro was, has now become the Challenger Series, and there's only about, probably going to be about 11 around the world. It's elevated, so what will happen is the Challenger Series will probably take place in the first quarter of the year, and then those that are wanting to go onto the CT will have to take part in the Challenger Series, but it will actually bring an amalgamation of the new up-and-comings and those that need to get back into the CT together. So that was going to take place anyway this year, and I think what it's done is just given more time for the WSL to reorganize themselves in the way they're going to present this tour. So from a sporting perspective, there's a lot of exciting new things happening, and it's just a way, it's now just more time for that to happen. I think from the perspective of us losing a major tourism event for this year, it is very sad, and it is quite a big knock on tourism and on the small business for this area, because I think if we take it back, the whole reason why we put in the bid for Bolito Pro to come to, well, back in the day it was the Mr. Price Pro, to come to Bolito, was because historically this town was very busy seasonally. So April was very busy, December was very busy, and before we had all the all the business popping up here, the middle year was very quiet. So July, June was very quiet, and the businesses in this area used to take strain. So we wanted to try and create some kind of economic and tourism drive to be able to get something for the hospitality industry, the retail, to have some kind of resources mid-year, so that it wasn't just reliant on April and December. And so that was the whole reason why we put the bid in 2009 for the Bolito Pro to be redirected here. And we bid against the South Coast, and luckily for us we were able to receive it. And back then we took it from Durban, and when it was in Durban, it was huge, it was massive, it was a massive event. And obviously coming to the Dolphin Coast, to Quadaguza, from such a big, from such a big venue, we basically had to restart from scratch. So, we started small. It wasn't what it was in the first year from, as it was in Durban, but we started small and we built and we slowly built, and now it's become that phenomenal event that all the businesses and all the people and communities of this area are able to benefit from. So in a way, it is sad that we don't have that mid-year income and that mid-year tourism boost, but it is giving us time to reboot, because we are going to be back next year. And quite interesting enough, our campaign this year, I don't want to give it away because we're actually just moving the campaign forward. So the way we're seeing this is that we're just moving our planning a few months ahead. So we're still on the same campaign, we're still going for the same drive, but just to give you a little bit of a highlight, our campaign this year was going to be celebrating the growth of the sport, celebrating the growth of the event, and obviously with the Olympics coming into play, and surfing being the first time in the Olympics, as well as skateboarding, our campaign, without giving it away, was going to be very much around the growth of the sport, the celebration of the legacy, and the celebration of the sport going into the Olympics. And so those events have also been postponed or cancelled. We're not using the word cancelled, we are using the word postponed, because actually we've just given ourselves a few more months. So The campaign is going to stay the same. It's about growth, and it is about celebrating the Olympics, and all these things have moved to next year, and we're moving along with it at the same time. I think what we're very fortunate to have in this region is a very progressive council. And so the council has been very pro-tourism development and very pro-small business development. And in all of this, as you know, they are the license holders of this event. And in all of this, they've always seen this event as a key economic driver for the region. And so as they're planning recovery strategies going out of this lockdown, this event, amongst a few other events, and tourism will become one of their very strong strategic recovery programs. So I think there is a lot of hope, and I think that sometimes in life we do need to reboot. So although we're going back, if you look at the legacy of this event, it's survived many things over the 50 years, and it's re-engineered itself. And I feel like we are re-engineering ourselves through this event, but also as business in this region and as community in this region, this is a way for us to re-engineer and to come back in a much better way. So it's about growth going forward for us.
Wow, Colette, so much excitement, even though it has been postponed. And like you say, it's just given a bit more time to restructure, replan, rethink.
I just want to encourage all the community and all the people out there. We want to still keep the story of the Pro alive. We want to still keep the story of what we have so great here. So the Pro is also about showcasing what amazing place we live in. It's about people come to visit this area during the, you know, during the window of the Pro, but it's about showcasing what they can do in this region outside of that. You know, we have amazing facilities here, we have amazing hospitality, we have amazing recreational facilities, we have amazing culture, and that's what the Pro actually does. It's a platform for economic development and to showcase what this region has for people to come all year round. Thanks for having me.
Thanks so much for joining us today, Colette. It's been an absolute pleasure seeing you again. And we'll keep our viewers informed of updates as to Bellito Pro for next year. To our viewers, for more information on the Vuvuzela, you can visit our website at www.thevuvuzela.co.za.